Good evening and welcome to St. Mark's United Methodist Church Christmas Eve service. This has not been a normal year, obviously. Many of our usual events have been canceled, but it is impossible to cancel Christmas Eve. The good news is that Christ came for such a time as this. He came to bring light during a dark moment in history and enters into the dark moments of our lives today. The good news is that we can and do believe, even now. We wish that you were here with us so we could celebrate Christmas Eve together. But we know that we will be together in spirit, you in your homes, and all of us in our own homes gathered together to celebrate with our families and, most importantly, with our Lord Jesus Christ. I want to show you something before we start, though. I'd like for Mark to pan outward and down onto the pews so you can see something very special. We have in all the pews, Peggy and John put together all of these luminaries. And these luminaries, for us, they symbolize your presence with us. So they're on the, they're lining the pews. There's like 10 in each pew. There's close to about 400, 360 to 400 luminaries in this sanctuary. And so you are here with us. Praise be to God. So come, all ye faithful. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Let's join our voices together in singing, O come, all ye faithful, verses 1, 2, 3, and 6.
O come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come ye, O come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. True God, light from light eternal, lo, he shuns not the virgin's womb. Son of the Father, begotten, not created, oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing an exaltation. Oh, sing, all ye citizens of heaven.
Christmas in the midst of a pandemic. We can gain inspiration from those who have faced their own dark times with faith. These words were found scrawled on the wall of a World War II internment camp. I believe in the sun, even when it's not shining. I believe in love, even when not feeling it. I believe in God, even when he is silent. Tonight, the Mislansky family help us to claim these words for our personal moment and assist us in lighting the Christ candle. And if you have a bulletin there at home with you, please join on the responses.
Even when the sun is hidden from sight,
even when the sun is hidden from sight,
even when love feels so remote,
even when love feels so remote,
even when God is silent,
even when God is silent,
even then we believe,
even then we believe.
We believe in the presence of Emmanuel, God with us.
This is the night we celebrate that the Holy came in human form to be light in our lives, to speak to us, touch us, comfort us, and call us.
Holy One, we thank you for the glimpse of heaven on earth in the faces and the light of those around us.
Even in the midst of fear, of challenge, of struggle, even when our view is obscured by clouds of doubt, you have ignited the flame of hope, love, joy, and peace within us.
Let us glow with its brilliance from the inside out. Amen.
Now let's join our voices together in singing the Christmas carol, Joy to the World.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive a king. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven. heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ. Wild fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.
Amen. All during Advent, we've been learning this special song, This Little Light of Mine. It's a song that many of us have grown up with, but we may not have ever known the sign language to it. And all during Advent, every week, we've been learning one verse each week of This Little Light of Mine. Peggy Smith, our Director of Children and Family Ministries, has been teaching us. Chris has been singing it. Peggy has been signing it for us. Tonight, we're doing all four verses for the kids and for all of us. So, Peggy, thank you.
Good evening. Like Pastor Joe said, all during the Advent season in this series, we have been learning together how to sign the words to This Little Light of Mine. Chris and I. Lights and candles are such an important part of the seasons of Advent and Christmas, and learning to sign the words to that song adds another dimension to all things bright and beautiful. So tonight we're going to sign the entire song together, letting our light shine, connected by the gift of love born in a stable and the gift of our special light that God has given to each one of us so that we can shine that light on the world. So, Mr. Chris.
All right, here we go. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bushel? No, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel? No, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel? No, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine all around the world. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine all around the world. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine all around the world. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
It has been so much fun learning to sign this song together. So go out, let your light shine, and have a very Merry Christmas.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 52, verses 7 through 10. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who brings the good news of peace, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, "Your God reigns." Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices, and together they sing for joy, for in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth together into singing, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God.
Tonight, I'm going to sing a song you will no doubt have heard on other Christmas Eve nights. But this time, listen with a new appreciation. When first written, this song was banned from church services because the writer's theology was deemed heretical. Some called him an atheist, and Adams's music was labeled as Jewish, the ultimate insult in Christian circles at a time when Gregorian chant was having a resurgence. Further, the song's message of humility and shared humanity went against the late 19th century idea that slaves did not have souls. Even though the church in France tried to kill the song, the American abolitionist and Unitarian minister John Sullivan Dwight made it popular in the Civil War era with its third verse proclaiming a radical message. Truly, he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppressions shall cease. Someday we will once again be able to join our full voices in song in this sanctuary. We will sing as never before. For now, we allow this song to be a prayer of hope that we will join hands and destroy the inequity that still haunts us.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. The King of Kings. kings lay thus in lowly manger, in all our trials, born to be our friend. He knows our need, to our weakness no stranger. King before the lowly man. Behold your king before him love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord, then ever, ever praise we his power.
For this Christmas Eve service, this is a special service indeed. And it's very special, again, because our own church family is going to be sharing the scriptures from their homes. Some of our younger families are presenting them to their kids, and so we look forward to seeing them. They'll be sharing Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 23, Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38, and Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20, and Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Interspersed between each reading, Sue and Chris will be leading us in singing carols, and members of our church family will offer their own gifts of music.
Now, the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit.
Our first carol is There's a Song in the Air, verses 1 and 2.
There's a song in the air, there's a star in the sky, there's a mother's deep prayer, and a baby's low cry. And the star rains its fire while the beautiful sing, for the manger of Bethlehem Christmas. There's a tumult of joy o'er the wonderful birth, for the virgin sweet boy is the Lord of the earth. Aye, the star rains its fire while the beautiful sing, for the manger of Bethlehem cradles a king.
And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, and he will save his people from their sins. All of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message to his prophet. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin brought to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end.
Now let's join together in singing Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, late in time, behold him come, offspring of a virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail incarnate deity, pleased with us in flesh to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lay his glory by, born that we no more may die, born to raise us from the earth, born to give a second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
Mary asked the angel, How can this happen? I am not married. The angel answered, The Holy Spirit will come down to you, and God's power will come over you. So your child will be called the Holy Son of God. Your relative Elizabeth is also going to have a son, even though she is old. No one thought she could ever have a baby, but in 3 months she will have a son. Nothing is impossible for God. Mary said, I am the Lord's servant. Let it happen as you have said. And the angel left her.
Hallelujah. It came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus, the emperor in Rome, that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to be taxed, each to his own city. And Joseph went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be taxed with Mary, his wife, who was soon to have a child.
Now let's join together in O Little Town of Bethlehem.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. O morning stars, together proclaim thy holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to all on earth. How silently, how silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his heaven. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child.
And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth.
And laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Baby boy, one day walk on water. Mary, did you know your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know your baby boy has come to make you new? This child calm a storm. of God. Mary, did you know?
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was, with the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Let's join together in a way in the manger.
Away in the manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the
had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
Then shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
I have traveled many moonless nights, cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry your song. I am waiting in a silent prayer. I am frightened by the load I bear. In a world as cold as stone, must I walk this path? Breath of heaven, breath of heaven. Breath of
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet."
"And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. You shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel."
Come, they told me, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, a newborn king to see, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, to lay before the king, pa rum pum pum pum, rum pum pum pum, rum pum pum pum. So to honor him, pa rum pum pum pum, when we come. Little baby, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, I am a poor boy too, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. I have no gift to bring, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, that's fit to give our king, pa rum pum pum pum, rum pum pum pum, rum pum pum pum. Shall I play for you, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. On my drum. Mary nodded, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. The ox and lamb kept time, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. I played my drum for him, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. I played my best for him, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum. Then he smiled at me, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. Me and my drum.
Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Now let's join together in the beautiful hymn, "What Child Is This?"
What child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Why lies he in such mean a state, where ox and ass are feeding? Good Christians, fear for sinners here, the silent word is pleading. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard. Shepherds, God, and angels sing.
This offering plate is symbolic of all of the gifts that you have given this season of Advent and all through the year during this horrible pandemic. We did not know how we were going to survive as a church, let alone have worship. How were we going to continue? Well, we continued because you remembered us. You remember us week after week and month after month. We give thanks to God for God's gracious gifts to us and for your response to God's gracious gift. Thank you for giving either through mail or through giving through our e-giving by just going to fairfieldstmarks.com and hitting that give. That is such a blessing to us. I also want to thank you for your continued support of our congregation, of our services, just through watching us live stream and also coming on a Sunday morning. This coming Sunday, December 27th, we will have our worship service in which we'll sing more hymns. Linda and I will be celebrating Christmas with family in out west in Phoenix, and we're blessed to have Sue and Chris lead the worship. The following Sunday, January 3rd, we are blessed to have Peggy lead worship along with Chris and Sue on the 3rd, and we'll hold off on celebrating communion until the 10th upon my return. So thank you, St. Mark's. This is a Christmas that we will not forget in many ways, but we give thanks that we are together. We are the Church of St. Mark's. Thank you.
Never was anyone like him. Never will one be the same. A tiny babe, an infant king, Savior. We worship and honor. Special delivery wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a dove, and filled with the Spirit, carried by grace. You know where he is going by the look on his face. He went, love was there also. Where he was, love showed the way. Those who saw knew he was holy, and I see what they saw to this very day. Oh, he came special. Spirit carried by grace.
by the look, by the look on my face.
We come to that classic moment of every Christmas Eve, the moment that we light our candles and we sing Silent Night. You know, we've wondered this year how we could possibly recreate a sense of normalcy in this moment. We wondered how we could get through it with the joy we usually feel on this night, having lost so much this year. I know it's not the same. You and I know it's not the same. We can be honest. And we know that because of the people we have lost, the jobs and security that we have lost, and that it will likely not, possibly not ever be the same. Surely every year we will remember this moment when we thought that perhaps light and song would elude us forever. But here we are. Here we are. We will light our lights, and we will have our song. Just like those soldiers in World War I, when the German soldiers and the English soldiers, they put down arms. And for that one night on Christmas Eve, they stopped for a short while their violence and sang together that all is calm and all is bright. You know, we've been so sorely divided on so many things. We're devastated by our losses, we are tired, and we are not so calm. But for this moment, this night, let us remember that we are not alone, and that we believe that the music and the light of God's promises come again and again. Hope for a better tomorrow, love that works for a more equitable world, joy that wells from a place deep within us, and peace that offers us the assurance that we need.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Beams
Friends, we wait for justice, but we do not wait to work for change. Well, Father, we thank you for this night, this holy night, which you've given us, Jesus, wrapped in swaddling clothes, laid in a manger as a poor baby, who came and lived among us, among his people, your people, who fed us, healed us, taught us, died for us, and was raised again, and whose light shines through us if we just allow it. Lord, we thank you for that amazing gift. Lord, may we be a reflection of that light, not just this night, but every night and every day. Lord, we pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. I'm going to share this, that we wait for restored health, but we do not wait to work to heal. We wait for wholeness, but we do not wait to work at binding brokenness. We wait for peace, but we do not wait to work to eliminate hatred. And so, my friends, like bells ringing out the news that Christ is born among us, fill the night left by sadness with messages of hope, love, joy, and peace. Go into your lives humming the tunes that keep that light alive in you and that spur you on in your work of justice and reconciliation with your friends, your family, with your neighbors. Raise your voices and repeat after me, do not be afraid.
Do not be afraid.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.